Sorry to keep you waiting. I've carried out the treatment as per Master Matoya's instructions. It should slow the destabilization of their corporeal ether quite significantly. But tell me, how fare our friends in the First? So this Beklug's the First leading authority on Soulcraft, are they? Sounds promising. And Uriange's proffered solution of white aurasite is rather ingenious now that I think of it. Well, while they press on with their preparations, you may rest assured we will continue to do our part here.
Oh, you're back. And none the worse for wear, I see.
Estinian! Oh, thank the gods! We've been worried sick. Did you lose your link pearl or something?
The situation in Garlemald has become more complicated. I was making my escape from the capital when I ran into one of yours, Riol. He thought it best we come straight here.
More complicated how?
Where to begin? After entering the Empire via Razat Han, I went about my mission of investigating Black Rose. It was then, inside a provincial factory, that I encountered the one who styles himself Shadow Hunter. Gaius Baelsar. Our goals being apparently aligned, we joined forces and ventured on into the heart of the capital, to the very Imperial Palace itself. There, we found a man whom all assumed dead. But his soul lives on, and he has wrested back his flesh. Xenos Ye Galvus. Nor did the surprises end there, for no sooner had we arrived than he murdered his sire in cold blood. The Emperor is dead. This sent Gaius into a rage, and he charged in, blade drawn. What's wrong?
taste my lance.
Are you all right?
Peer into my past, did you?
Well, I didn't quite relive the experience as you did, but I bore witness to it all.
I'm still not sure what I think of this gift of yours, but no matter. Our confrontation was cut short when the Imperial Guard arrived. It was then that Xenos took his leave, citing boredom.
To think their research into the Echo could bear such fruit. Escaping death, jumping from one body to the next, and returning to his own after all this time. He is an Ascian in all but name.
It beggars belief, aye. But no more than hero traversing the rift between worlds. My concerns are far more prosaic. With the Emperor dead and the Crown Prince missing, the Empire is in disarray. Until order is restored, assuming it even possible, we needn't fear an Imperial reprisal. And for reasons of his own, Xenos took it upon himself to rid the world of Black Rose. Riol has already gone to apprise the Alliance leaders of these developments. We may leave the matter in their hands for now.
Then perhaps we have seen the last of the fighting at Gimlet. Though, if it comes to civil war, I cannot help but fear for the provinces. Ah, I'd nearly forgotten to ask. What became of Gaius? Did he not escape with you?
That he did, but we parted ways shortly after leaving Garlemald. He claimed another threat had arisen which demanded his attention. He didn't elaborate, but the absence of some device or other in the capital gave him reason to believe they're planning something. Lest you worry, I believe he has well and truly shed the Black Wolf's pelt. Conquest is no longer his objective. We may safely leave him to his own devices.
Well, it's nice to have one less foe to worry about, even if we do have a mysterious new threat to look out for instead. Speaking of which, I'll see that Riol and our shinobi are made aware, though we still know next to nothing. It can't hurt to be vigilant.
Well then, with Black Rose nipped in the bud, I believe I've fulfilled my part of the bargain.
That's true, but with the Archon still slumbering away,
We were hoping you might agree to stay with us for a little bit longer.
Sorry, but I'm not inclined to extend my contract. Gaius isn't the only one with business to attend to.
Thank you for your help then, Estinian. I see why Alfno admires you so.
Farewell, my friend. See that you don't make a habit of dozing off in battle.
I suppose we should all be getting on then. As ever, we will see to the Archon's needs. In the meantime, why not get some rest? You've more than earned it. Go on.
They're here, Commander.
And I, for one, am grateful that they are. Told you've been busy since our paths last crossed at the Gimlet Dark. Not that I understand half of it. When the Scions spoke of other worlds, I'd struggle to describe what I pictured. Mayhap things would seem clearer were I to hear the tale from your own lips. But I'm afraid the situation will not afford us that luxury. I trust you two require no introduction.
We meet again, Hero of Eorzea. Must we repeat this ridiculous display? I pose no threat to you, though what I come to warn you of very well might.
Had he meant to do us harm, I hazard he would have kept to the shadows and brought more than two companions. We need not pretend to be the best of friends, but I hope we can put aside our differences for the present.
As you are doubtless aware, Sir Estinian and I cooperated to rid the world of Black Rose in your absence. Our journey together took us as far as the Imperial Palace, where we witnessed Emperor Varus meet his death at Xenos's hand. Being the sole witnesses to this crime, and in no position to defend our innocence, we were then forced to flee, each pursuing his own avenue of escape. When we were later reunited, Estinian claimed to have encountered an unfamiliar kind of machina during his flight, but to me his description seemed anything but, and upon further investigation I found that I was right. The Empire is developing a new Ultima weapon.
What, that Alagon monstrosity, created to vanquish primals? With which you yourself once thought to conquer Eorzea?
The same. In my foolishness, I sought to harness its power, and became the Ascian's pawn in so doing. But you know as well as I how that tale ended. The weapon itself, excavated from beneath this very city, was destroyed ere we could fully unravel its secrets, and that should have been the end of it. But unlikely as it sounds, the Empire's efforts to recreate it have somehow borne fruit, primarily through secret research conducted by the 7th Imperial Legion, it would seem.
Wait, the 7th was all but annihilated at Cartano, along with its legatus.
Indeed, few survived. The 7th, as it is now, has little in common with the Legion led by Vandarnas. And its leadership has changed hands several times since. Precisely how this project has continued despite such turmoil, and under whose auspices, remains a mystery. What we do know, however, is that a number of prototypes have been produced, and that one of them is on its way to Eorzea. We attempted to stop it, but it was all we could do to slow its progress, so we resolved instead to bring you warning.
And right glad are we that you did, though it soundly dashed our hopes that tensions might ease at last.
As it is, we've begun to strengthen our presence in the Gimlet Dark, and are assembling a force to meet the coming threat. Before you say anything, I know full well you have pressing concerns of your own. Your comrades remain in peril, and I would not ask you to forsake them. But the fact remains that you, and you alone, have faced the Ultima weapon, and emerged victorious. We need you. And so, when the time comes, if your comrades can spare you, I bid you lend us your strength. I've assigned an officer to await your word.
The Ascian's downfall was to be the work of my remaining days, but it was my hand that kindled these flames, and I cannot allow them to spread any further. I will do what I must to see this mistake consigned to history once and for all. Even if it means begging your aid, the fates will enjoy the irony, even as I endure the ignominy.
I too shall make for the border and offer my skills, meager though they seem in such company. Mayhap we shall meet there anon.
Though we can ill afford to ignore the coming of a new Ultima weapon, our friend's plight grows ever more precarious, and none save you can join them in the first. I only hope you are not forced to make a choice.
Thank you.